if I drove a Cadillac. Well, 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 Elvis, he had it all. They say he was the king.
Yeah, you know we need them. We always need them. Those strategies for living. So are you ready? You ready for your daily dose of radio rehab?
Listen, I don't care who you are.
You do.
You need it. You need your strategies for living.
We do. We certainly do. No question about it. Hey, folks, welcome. Welcome into 101.7 FM. 710 Keel, welcome into another edition of Strategies for a Living. I'm Dr. David McMillan. He is Jimmy Bryant, PhD. That means he produces, he hosts, and he directs. She is Lauren Leon McMillan, PLPC. And you know, here we are, just three folks sitting around that love the movies.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
Right?
That's right.
Is there anything better? Well, yeah, there is. There is something better than the movie. The Robinson Film Center.
Oh, well, that's
what's wrong with you?
That's like refined to the max. I mean, that's it.
You know,
penultimate.
I love to talk about the movies. I love to talk about the Robinson Film Center. So we're all going to love the fact that Wendell Riley, executive director of the Robinson Film Center, is our life strategist.
I don't think there's anyone better to have.
I would agree. We're going to talk about, we've been talking about Abby Singer's Bistro and the new look and the new menu. We're going to hear all about that. Plus, the Robbies are coming up Saturday, June the 15th. We're going to talk a lot about that.
Yeah.
All things Robinson Film Center this evening here on Strategies for a Living. And we are brought to you by the Robinson Film Center and by Azalea Cleaners and by Pintail Roofing.
Roof.
And by Learning RX and by Hempress Cannabis with Love. And by the Shreveport Little Theater, our life strategist this evening, Wendell Riley from the Robinson Film Center. Buckle your seatbelt and come back. We got a lot to talk about today. You're going to see the difference. When you go to Azalea Cleaners, you'll hear about it too. Azalea Cleaners has been fine dry cleaning since 1958, plus laundry, alterations and repairs, comforters, wedding gown cleaning and restoration. You'll hear about it from your friends because they'll see it too. They'll notice the Azalea difference. Azalea is convenient. 732 Azalea Drive, 9220 Ellerby Road, and 9227 Mansfield Road. Plus, the front door of your home or business with Azalea's delivery on demand. Just text SETUP to 249-8283 and Azalea will pick up your clothes and deliver them back clean and fresh to you. You can't get closer than that. That's the Azalea difference. You'll notice it right away. Others will too. The Azalea difference. Fine dry cleaning since 1958. Text SETUP to 249-8283 and get the Azalea difference. AzaleaCleaners.com. And welcome in. Welcome into 101.7 FM, 710 Keel. Welcome into Strategies for Living. Jimmy Bryant, PLPC, Lauren Leon McMillan, David McMillan. Let's welcome back one of my very favorite life strategists.
The one and only.
I don't know. You know, is there enough time to say what I need to say about this guy? I've loved him from almost the first moment I met him. He's finally I met him at LSU Shreveport, but he finally matriculated. Is that the right word?
That is the right
okay,
word.
Okay, yes. I was hoping so.
He graduated to the movies.
Yeah.
Grew up
and now is executive director of the Robinson Film Center. And, you know, we are so blessed that the Robinson is here, and I'm doubly blessed that Wendell Robinson. How long have you been? A little over a year now?
I'm going into the end of my second year.
Wow, time flies, doesn't it?
Time flies when you're having fun, yeah.
Yeah. Welcome to Strategies for Living.
Thank you. And thank you for being here. Thank you for that amazing intro.
Well, I didn't cover everything because I should have said, you know, you've spent X number of years in education, you know, your movie background, all of that. If I did all of that, we wouldn't have time to talk about the Robbies and Abby Singer Bistro, right?
Yeah, that's true. I mean, I am here to talk about some stuff.
How did you get to town?
Initially?
Yeah.
My ex-wife and I moved here for work. She's actually a faculty member at LSU.
But then you caught on.
I stumbled into the animation industry here, and I had the opportunity to work on some amazing projects with some amazing people.
Yeah. Bill Joyce et al.
Yeah, absolutely.
We're glad that you've landed where you've landed.
Well, thank you. Yeah, me too.
You've done some amazing things in the couple of years at Robinson Film Center. It was already a wonderful place. And, man, you can feel. You can feel it when you walk into the door, Wendell.
Thank you. My first goal at RFC was just not to mess it up. Because RFC is a miracle, right? That's the way I describe it. It's a wonderful place here in Shreveport, and we're
so blessed.
Yeah.
Because there's only a handful of these centers. Let's talk just a second about the center itself.
Yeah.
Because I don't know that we all appreciate the uniqueness of the Robinson, because around the country, there's only a handful of these independent. I mean, how do we describe the Robinson?
We are an independent art house theater.
Yeah.
And there are not many of those around the U.S. I mean, people come from larger cities and they're like, we don't have something.
Yeah. Else, yeah. How in the world did we score this?
Well, it just came about because people in Shreveport who loved film said, I am tired of driving to Dallas to watch movies that I want to see.
Mm-hmm.
And we should build something here. And it was this group of people that would kind of find sites around town and they would watch films and discuss them after. And then ultimately they decided that it needed a permanent home. And with the help of the DDA and the city of Shreveport and some major donors, they actually built this crazy thing.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. And I'm so glad that they did.
Yeah. And it's kind of a full circle thing for me personally, because when I got to Shreveport, it was a change of pace for us. We came from Southwest Virginia.
Right.
And, I was looking for, does this town have a comic shop? Does it have good pizza? And does it have cool movie theaters? And RFC had just been built and it was brand new. It had that new car smell.
It had that sparkle to it.
Yeah. And I was like, this place is amazing. And so now being able to work there every day, 15 years later, is just, it feels great.
Well, we've got a lot to talk about today. We want to talk about the Robbies. We want to talk about Abby Singer's Bistro. What do you want to talk about first?
Well, I mean, I just, I want to always remind people that the two things about Robinson, we are a nonprofit,
right?
But we really are here to serve the Shreveport community. We're not here just to make money. We are here to educate, enrich, and entertain through film.
Right.
So film literacy is a big part of what we do. Film education is a big part of what we do. And I think that's lost sometimes. I think people engage with us through going to the movies or coming to the bistro, and that's great. We want that.
Sure.
But a lot of times people don't understand that every dollar that they spend at RFC helps support film education in this community.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And, it's important, and I know you it feels like probably from the chair that you sit in that you're fundraising all year long.
Yeah. Yeah. For sure.
What nonprofit doesn't, let's face
it. Exactly.
And not just in Shreveport, but every place.
Yeah.
It's important. But it's important for people to hear and be reminded. It's important for all of us to be reminded. This is a nonprofit. And so, it depends on all of us
for
to support
sure.
it. And we can support it in a lot of different ways.
Exactly.
We're going to talk about that this evening. One of the ways, and I'm speaking personally, Lauren can vouch for me. When we go to the movies, you look and you see what's going to be on, what's on. If there's a movie playing at the Robinson, that's going to take precedence for us that we want to see.
Yeah.
And even if it's playing in another theater,
we're
going to the Robinson.
Well, we all appreciate that. And we work really hard to pick films that we think will have some cultural significance, right? Some relevance for folks who want something other than like the big noisy sci-fi films, which I love.
Right.
Sure.
But, you know, we try to challenge our audience. We try to show films that, you know, people who think about things and want to kind of experience the world in a different way.
Yeah, make us think and expand and absolutely. Our horizons and
absolutely.
Perspectives.
And walk in other people's shoes,
right.
You know.
Yeah,
we show a lot of international films. We have a Japanese film showing right now, and that is playing against a film about an autistic boy played by an autistic actor.
Wow.
Phenomenon. That's Ezra, right?
That is Ezra. Absolutely. Yeah. And we spend a lot of time talking about the films that we bring to RFC.
How far away, how far out do those films have to be booked?
Well,
so when we're seeing Evil Does Not Exist is on right now as we speak, and Ezra's on right now, The Holdovers is coming back up.
Yeah.
How far out?
So it depends on the film and it depends on the studio. We knew we were booking Evil Does Not Exist for several months.
Mm-hmm.
But Ezra, I booked that maybe 2 weeks ago.
Oh, wow.
You know, so
there's opportunities that come up.
Oh, yeah.
And that's one of the things then with a center like the Robinson, you can shift and move pretty quickly.
Yeah, we have some flexibility, and we also, a lot of this is predicated on the relationship that we have with our booker,
right?
And they go to the studios on our behalf, and you know, we are a little fish in a big industry.
Sure. But you've got there's quite a story to tell.
Yeah. And we have a reputation of being a good cinema. You know, we work with integrity, and that helps us get the kinds of films that we get.
Yeah. Now, since you've come in and in this last couple of years, I don't want to put you on the spot or anything, but what are you proudest of? What are you proudest of last couple of years?
You know, this will sound like humble bragging, but just being able to do the work, you know, because I believe in film. I believe in the power of film. I'm from a small Caribbean island, and I grew up on American cinema, American and British cinema.
Right.
Because it was all international cinema to us.
Right.
And now to come full circle, and I have those moments, literally. I had one yesterday where I'm just walking through the theater, the empty theater, and I smell it and and I feel the coolness of it, and it just takes me back. It's this lifelong love of cinema that I've had.
Yeah.
So I am proud that I actually get to do that every single day.
Absolutely. Yeah.
You're living your passion.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly. Yeah.
It takes me back. You know, Wendell and Lauren, I'm showing my age, but back when I was growing up as a little guy, there were several movie theaters. Downtown was where the movie theaters were.
You know?
So when I was growing up, the Don Theater was downtown, and the Strand was still a movie theater back then. Then there was the Capri.
Yeah.
I'm probably missing one more.
Yeah.
I think there was one down there named the Joy.
Those were single screen theaters. Right.
Right. Correct.
That was very similar to the experience I had growing up. We didn't have Cineplexes back then.
Yeah.
And each theater had their own specialties. Like they, you know, one showed A films, one showed B movies, one showed like martial arts films.
Oh, it was a big deal when the Shreve City Cinema opened up.
With two screens.
It's now a mattress shop. But when two screens opened up as the Shreve City Cinema, and it was owned by the same company that ran the Don downtown.
Yeah.
That was a big deal. Yeah. But I remember catching the bus when I was in middle school. A friend of mine and I would catch the bus on Saturday afternoon and drive. You know, it seemed like a long ride back then. It was just over the Texas Street Bridge, but to spend Saturday afternoon at the movies.
Yeah, man.
And so it brings me back every time I walk into the Robinson and smell the popcorn. It brings me right back to some place that I love being.
That makes my heart happy to hear that.
Yeah, and I hope more and more of us will take that journey back.
But
it's so easy. You've made it so easy.
Well, we try, and it's easy for us to put ourselves in the shoes of the people that come to RFC because we're movie nerds too, right?
So
we sit around and we talk about movies that we love, movies we hate. But cinema as a whole is just it's just a passion for us. So we try to give people the experience where they come in and they feel that same thing. And it's a special thing because it's, you know, people share the experience of going to movies, mm-hmm. whether you're going with your partner or your kids. A lot of times people come, you see like two or three generations coming to see yes. some of the repertory films that we show, right. some of the older movies, and to hear them talking about it as they're coming out, or it, you know, this is the first time like a 15-year-old has seen something on the big screen.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
it's a movie that they've watched with their grandmother on TV like every year or something like that.
That's so powerful.
Yeah, it is. Yeah.
That's so powerful from a family point of view and just from a thought-provoking point of view.
Yeah.
Stretch us all. When we come back from this break, I want to dive in. Let's talk about the Robbies, because the Robbies are something very special
for sure.
about the Robinson Film Center. And the Robbies are coming up Saturday, June the 15th. We're going to talk about it. And Wendell Riley, Executive Director of the Robinson Film Center, is our life strategist today, talking all things Robinson Film Center. And we will be right back here on Strategies for Living.
This is Jay Merle for Pintail Roofing. Let's talk about quality. When you hire Pintail to build your roof, here's what you can expect. Quality and quality control are the most important concerns for us at Pintail, and you need to know that Pintail stands tall with swift and professional performance on any warranty call. This is our most important policy. And remember, we're your neighbors. We'll be here for you for the long haul. Our family's lived here for over 100 years, and we aren't going anywhere. On the commercial side of Pintail's business, our fluid-applied roofing solutions can save thousands of dollars over conventional commercial roofing options. Call Pintail at 226-ROOF for a free inspection of your home or commercial building. That's 226-7663. Pintail Roofing. What's the condition of your roof?
And welcome back. Welcome back into 101.7 FM. 710 Kia, welcome back into Strategies for Living. Lauren and Jimmy, you're just beside yourself in there, aren't you? You know, you're in your element with.
Well, and I'm listening.
Yeah,
you know, I'm listening. Yeah. I'm learning, and I'm just soaking it up.
There you go.
Like anytime someone from RFC comes, like you guys are always the cream of the crop, and so I just like to just try and get some pixie dust on me.
Okay. I'll give an amen to that, brother. We are with Wendell Riley, Executive Director of the Robinson Film Center. Let's talk about the Robbies. It's a night of suspense. It's a night of intrigue. It's a night of glitz and glamour, but fun. All benefiting Robinson Film Center.
Yeah, it's our big fundraiser for the year. And it's the time of year when we get to celebrate film. But we get, more importantly, we get to celebrate the people who support us, right? So we try to make it fun and glamorous. We have a red carpet. There, you know, people take pictures and stuff. I mean, some of these, the ladies especially, they go all out.
Yeah.
You know, they get dressed up in these amazing gowns and stuff like that. And this year, the theme is Alfred Hitchcock. Who you might have heard of. Made a couple movies. Yeah, exactly.
I'm not sure I did that real well, but.
No,
yeah.
You nailed it.
Okay.
Nailed it. But yeah, so, but it's fashion in Hitchcock films, because Hitchcock is known for his like dashing, leading ladies, and the debonair
gentlemen.
Hitchcock
liked the ladies, didn't he?
And he had a very specific. But we won't talk about that.
Yeah. Well, wait for the Robbies.
We'll see. Yeah. I'm
but
sure.
but it, you know, lots of fashion and stuff like that. But the entire center is going to be decked out in Alfred Hitchcock iconography. You know, films like The Birds will be represented, North by Northwest, Rear Window. There's a little bit of Psycho in there as well.
Ooh.
But we also, in transforming the space, we'll have DJs throughout. I think we have three DJs. We have a live performance by Identity Crisis, which is a local band. They played the show last year.
Right.
And then we will have a screening room where we're showing Hitchcock films, and we'll also have a karaoke room.
Oh,
yeah. Wow. That was a big hit last year.
It's going to be a true party.
Oh, yeah. It's a blast. Yeah.
So if I'm going to do the karaoke room, then I probably need some of those specialty cocktails.
Well, what I would say is a lot of people in the karaoke room would have already been drinking specialty cocktails. So your voice will sound amazing to anybody who's in there.
Take note of that, would you, Lauren?
Yeah. Yeah. I might have to go to the bathroom.
So I can dine at Abby Singer's. I can get the specialty cocktails. It's the dazzling entertainment. It's the activities. All 7 o'clock, June the 15th, Saturday, June the 15th. What do I need to do if I want to be a part of this?
If you want to be a part of it, we have tickets on sale at our website, robinsonfilmcenter.org. But we are also still looking for sponsors. So one of the ways that people get tickets for the Robbies is they do sponsorships with us.
Okay.
And part of the sponsorship packet includes tickets. So if there are any corporations out there or businesses who want to get the word out, we celebrate our businesses throughout the year.
Right.
So we put them on our screens. We've got over 50,000 people that run through the space every year watching films and coming and eating. So there are a lot of eyeballs.
So from a business perspective, there's a lot of bang for the buck here.
Yeah, 1,000%. And we go really all out to try to make sure that people get value for their sponsorships.
So if you would like to talk to Wendell about a sponsorship, it's not too late.
No.
The business can be big or small, because I know we've got a lot of smaller, medium sized businesses here in our community that are looking for bang for the buck,
and
for their marketing dollar.
100%, and sponsorships start as low as $1,000, and they go all the way up to, we have a $50,000 sponsorship as well.
Right.
So if you have 50K, Lauren, just give me a call.
Definitely. Robinson would be my first place.
Thank you.
Yeah. I'll send her after the program.
That's great. But and we're doing live mentions throughout the evening. So even people there, they'll get their names read on stage. Bisky Duncan, who is a local news anchor, she is going to be our host of the evening. And of course,
Bisky
looks like she just walked out of a Hitchcock film because she's got the short blonde hair.
Absolutely.
Yeah, and she likes vintage clothing and stuff like that.
Yeah.
It's going to be fun.
It'll be an entirely fun night. So robinsonfilmcenter.org for tickets. Not too late to get in on the sponsorship. Just give a call and chat with Wendell.
Yeah. Sponsorship information's on the website. But, of course, if someone wants to speak to me about it, they can call our main number. The phone number's on our website. And just talk to Alexis, and she'll put you through.
There you go. This has got to be fun to put this together and to plan and, the theme coming together. And what's it feel like? I mean, you're just around the corner now.
It's exciting. Honestly, we're just kind of a little nervous because everything's going smoothly. And that makes people people who've worked in production before, it's like, no. It makes for really fun meetings because you get to talk about like really absurd things like, how many birds are we going to put in the lobby?
I love it.
Hanging a giant prop plane from the ceiling in the bistro for the VIP room. Are we allowing people to be half nude when they take photos in the photo booth if it's the psycho? So the answer is no. The answer is no.
Yeah, okay. You could have left a little bit of suspense. No, you're not going to do that.
I don't like mixing alcohol with...
I got you.
Get a little tricky.
Yeah. It get tricky, yeah.
I understand.
But it's a lot of fun putting that stuff together. And it's all with real love and passion and wanting to put our best foot forward for the community when they come in, because we want people to be blown away.
Absolutely. And I think if you've experienced the Robbies before, and I know a lot of people make it, this is a yearly event.
Yeah.
I mean, it's on the calendar and they wouldn't miss it. If you've never been before, why don't you take a look at it this year, and you'll find it'll probably end up on your calendar year after year after year. You'll see why people come back year after year to the Robbies.
100%. And again, there's the added benefit of knowing that, you know, coming and having a blast, and, you know, with every ticket you get free food and drink, but it's also supporting us in our mission.
Absolutely.
And so, you know, you are directly helping young kids with us exposing them to cinema and possible careers in film. And that's a big topic of conversation right now with 50 Cent potentially coming to Shreveport. Sure. Not potentially, he is coming to Shreveport.
What are your thoughts about?
I've been saying potentially for so long.
Exactly. Right. What are your thoughts about that?
I'm very excited about it. Listen, any production that comes to Shreveport helps our film community.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
The big thing, the thing that separates this from other investors and people who have tried to engage with the city of Shreveport is that he recognizes the need for wraparound services and additional industries that are adjacent to film. So his idea is, if we're trying to recruit people to come from, say, Hollywood or Atlanta or New Orleans to come live and work in Shreveport,
right,
we have to give them the types of creature comforts that they're used to.
Right.
So he is looking at investing in other businesses, and the production will sort of take care of itself.
Right.
And that's always been the challenge for us. It's the thing that we've been working on here after the post-Katrina boom went back south, right, is that we've recognized the need for building infrastructure to support the film industry.
Right.
Right. There's a mountain of jobs that are available, technical jobs, but you have to train people up to.
They have to be ready.
Yeah.
Right.
So an electrician can work on a movie set, but he or she have to be trained for that.
Right, because it's a specialty.
It's a specialty thing, but it's not that. It, you know, we in educating people about film is that we try to demystify it.
Right,
like it's just a job. It's a trade.
Right,
but you can have fun doing really cool stuff. And
if your deal is electrical, or if your deal is carpentry, you can have a blast.
Yeah, instead
doing your thing.
Right, instead of crawling around in like a 120 degree attic trying to lay cable, you can do that on a film set. It might be 120 degrees, but you're probably standing next to like Charlize Theron or something like that.
There you go. Well, that makes it all worthwhile. Yeah.
If you're into that kind of stuff, you know, for a nerd like me, that's heaven, right?
Yeah.
I love it. I love it. And you know, you mentioned the young people coming up this summer.
Summer camp.
The film camps this summer, right?
Yeah, and we have you know, the first one's already sold out because it's very popular.
Yeah.
But also this is that moment where kids are exposed to what filmmaking actually is, and
right,
again, demystifying it, making them understand some of the skills, life skills that go into it. And we always like to say, even when I worked with Gregory Kallenberg at Film Prize Junior, we like to say, even if a kid goes through a program like that and they never work a day in film, they would still come away with really meaningful life skills, like time management,
right,
people management,
right,
you know, being able to work in teams, understanding processes and, you know, project management. These are all things, no matter what industry you go into, you're going to have to do that on some level.
Absolutely.
So it's
real life.
Yeah. And we can kind of trick kids into learning this stuff by doing
something. Because they're having
cool.
So much fun. Yeah, they're having a blast while they're doing it.
Yeah. They're making a monster movie, you know, and they're just having fun. And, you know, some people just kind of grow up into that. And when you work in film, you get to play for a living. I mean, it's hard work, but you do. It's like you're playing dress up, right?
Yeah.
I mean, it's literally what it is.
Yeah. Yeah. I love it. So the Robbies are coming up Saturday, June the 15th. Tickets are now on sale. RobinsonFilmCenter.org. With the general admission, there's a lot of perks that come with it. There's access to the Grand Ballroom, the Willis Knighton Screening Room, the Kennedy Karaoke Room. There's light hors d'oeuvres. There's an open bar with beer and wine and well liquor. There's free valet parking, all of that. And you can find out much more. Maybe you want to go the VIP route.
Yeah.
You can find out all about that at RobinsonFilmCenter.org. Wendell Riley is our life strategist today here on Strategies for Living. We're going to come back talk about, you know, have you been to the new Abby Singer's Bistro? I mean, I was going to say improved, but it was already pretty doggone good. So the new Abby Singer's Bistro, we're going to talk about that coming back here on Strategies for Living with Wendell Reilly today. Be right back. You know, there's just no place like the Robinson Film Center, 617 Texas Street, downtown Shreveport, robinsonfilmcenter.org. There's always something going on at the Robinson. You know, the Robbies are coming up Saturday, June the 15th, and you can find out all the information on the Robbies at robinsonfilmcenter.org. And, you know, summer film camps are just around the corner, too. They're in June 24th through the 28th. That's Movie Monster Camp. And then July the 8th through the 12th is Suspense Camp. You can find out all about that at robinsonfilmcenter.org. Don't forget Abby Singer's Bistro, second floor, open for lunch and dinner. Join the crowd. Join the fun. Become a member. Get discounts on movies, concession upgrades, and bistro deals at RFC, 617 Texas Street, downtown Shreveport, robinsonfilmcenter.org. And welcome back. Welcome back into 101.7 FM, 710 Keel. Welcome back into Strategies for Living. Jimmy Bryant, PLPC, Lauren Leon McMillan, David McMillan, Wendell Reilly, our life strategist today. He is, of course, from the Robinson Film Center, and he's executive director, having a ball. I can't believe it's been almost, it's 2 years. Yeah. Where does time go?
I don't know, man.
Yeah.
I don't know.
But you're going to have to come back and talk about that. Baby, you know, you.
We can talk about time.
We can talk about time. Yeah.
Time is a flat circle.
Now yes, you're blowing my mind. Okay, so let's talk about Abby Singer's Bistro, newly renovated dining room. It's now open. Abby Singer's was already one of our, Lauren and I, how many times you see us there, right?
Yeah, for sure.
But it was a perfect date night. So it was already wonderful, but it is now officially reopened after a full renovation.
Yeah, it looks completely different. We did everything. We did lighting, floors, paint. We put up a mural. We changed some of the decor, new furniture as well, and a new menu. Oh, and we also addressed the bar area.
Yeah, the bar looks completely different.
It's much brighter and more welcoming.
Yeah. This is the 15th anniversary of RFC, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Correct.
And so kind of it needed to do something.
Yeah.
I don't know where 15 years has flown by.
Well, that's the thing. Yeah. You blink and, you know, all of a sudden, you know, some of the furniture is not as new as it used to be. And the paint doesn't look as good as it used to. So we recognized that it was time.
Yeah.
And
The 15th anniversary, you decided to kind of go back to the roots.
Yeah.
Going back to the roots as a bistro.
As a bistro.
Yeah.
Exactly. Yeah. We simplified a lot of the menu, made some of the dishes. You know, we want to do fast, casual food.
Right. Right.
That is delicious, mostly healthy. but food that you can eat while you're watching a film, because that's one of the cool things about Abby Singer's is you can order upstairs and you can have it delivered to you while you're watching your movie.
Absolutely.
You can have a cocktail in the theater. You can have a beer. You can have wine. Or you can just do popcorn, right? It's like you choose your own adventure. But we wanted to update the menu, kind of make it fresh and fun. We added some silly names to them, like, you know.
Movie names,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah, like the Chicky Chicky Bang Bang for the chicken sandwich or, you know, the spaghetti western.
Yeah.
That's our chicken spaghetti dish. Yeah. So, yeah, I mean, again, we love movies, but and you know, for me as executive director, I want people, when they walk through the door, if somebody blindfolded them and sort of put them anywhere in that building, I want them to immediately recognize that they're in a place that celebrates film.
Absolutely.
And so that was the part of the impetus behind redoing the menu in the bistro and the redesign of it.
Now, the bistro is open Tuesday through Thursday for lunch. Opens up at 11 o'clock. So if you're downtown and looking for a place, Abby Singer's Bistro is a wonderful place to catch lunch.
It's great, yeah. Our lunch crowd is, we have a good lunch crowd. And we also have the only balcony mm-hmm. in
And
in
that's wonderful,
Shreveport.
Yeah.
So it's
yeah.
great for lunch, but it's also great. It's very romantic at night mm-hmm. Or in the evening when you see the sun setting over the church and, you know, you're sitting there and you're having a glass of wine.
Cocktail yeah. or a glass of wine. Yeah, it's wonderful. Good stuff. Yeah. 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 I can look across and of course, it's Rhino Coffee now. But, you know, that was the old Sears building.
Yeah.
I don't quite remember that. I'm not that old, but wow. almost. almost.
Where was the, was there a Woolworths building?
Yes, downtown? Yes, there was. It was right down the block there.
Gotcha. Yeah.
And I do remember that. I'm aging myself, but that's I remember right. Woolworth, and I remember the, you know, having the soda fountain in Woolworth.
Yeah. 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 And, you know, that's a big part of what we try to remind people is that RFC has been a cornerstone of the development of downtown.
Yes.
The redevelopment. Because when I came to Shreveport in 2009, downtown, there wasn't much there. And RFC was already there, but there wasn't anything around it. Now we have Rhino. Now we have people who live downtown.
Yes.
We have Poppin' Pizza. We have...
And we've got more and more coming.
Yeah. And it's really exciting. And, you know, for us, it's not about competition. I want as many restaurants downtown as possible.
Absolutely. Because you want that variety.
Yeah, and people know that it's a destination. Like, that's the thing. We want people not just to come down for RFC. I love when people say, well, I'm going to go to Rhino first and have a cup of coffee, and then, or maybe do that after the movie. So I do a meal at Abby's. I watch the movie, and then I go over to Rhino to talk about the film.
There you go.
I mean, it doesn't get better than that. Right?
Absolutely. So open Tuesday through Thursday from 11 to 2 for lunch and 5 to 8 for dinner Friday. It's, of course, 11 to 2 for lunch and 5 to 9 for dinner. Happy hour every day between 4 and 6, and Saturday 5 to 9. Bistro is closed Sunday and Monday. Got to take a rest.
Yeah, we do sleep sometimes.
Sometimes?
Yeah.
We do that.
Yeah.
And Mondays kind of give you a day to regroup, don't they?
Yeah, Mondays, it's a very productive day for staff because we get to catch up on all the stuff that, you know, we weren't able to get to when we have folks in the building. Because when they're in the building, we try our best to take care of them.
Now, if I just have to have, you know, you mentioned it and Lauren heard it. Notice he said all the food is healthy.
Yeah.
So Royale with cheese. If I need my Royale with cheese.
I do believe he said mostly.
I heard him say all of it. Maybe I heard wrong.
Well, you can get the Royale as a vegetarian burger. You can get a black bean burger.
Oh, see?
Yeah, the black bean burger is really good.
You're not really helping.
He's speaking my language
now. You're not really helping me much here, Wendell. But yeah, I know.
I love it. See, he was on your side just a moment ago.
Did you catch that?
Here's the deal: if I have to have one, whether it's if it's vegetarian or mine, you know, of course, mine is it has to bleed a little bit.
Yeah.
I can get DoorDash delivery if I need it.
Yeah,
and I can order and pick up online, right?
Yeah,
and that's another way to support RFC.
For sure. I mean, listen, we want people to come and sit and eat, but if your schedule is too busy, you can do DoorDash and you can order it that way.
I do encourage, you know, if you're catching a movie and a film, you're doing a date night kind of book a reservation because the bistro is intimate. You know, and so, you know, you want to make sure you've got a table.
Yeah, Friday and Saturday nights, we get busy. So, you know, one of the things that we always tell patrons, if you're there to see a film, make sure you give yourself enough time to have a meal. Don't show up 20 minutes before and then sit down and try to order if you're wanting to eat in the restaurant.
Yeah.
But yeah, on weekends, I would always recommend making a reservation.
Yeah. And easy to do. You can go to robinsonfilmcenter.org and check out all of this. Don't forget to check out membership. If you're not a member, you're not a member, how important is membership to RFC, that's, Wendell?
That's one of the things that keeps us going. Yeah. And the membership model is really beneficial to folks who apply and become members every year. We have memberships starting as low as $55. It's an individual membership.
Right.
But you get coupons to the bistro. You get free movie tickets.
A lot of freebies come with the membership.
Yeah, you get discounts. There are a lot of perks that come with becoming a member of RFC. But memberships, that's a, if you are like, hey, listen, I don't have a ton of money, but I want to support this nonprofit.
Right.
Get a membership, you know.
That's the way.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because, again, every dollar that of the memberships, a portion of that goes directly into our education programs.
Whether you want to find out about the upcoming Robbies, that's Saturday, June the 15th, and I hope you will. Whether you want to find out more about Abby Singer's Bistro, whether you want to find out more about membership, or you just want to check out what's showing right now and how do I get tickets, what's coming up, what's coming soon, how about the educational opportunities, all of that at robinsonfilmcenter.org. Wendell Riley, our life strategist today, here on Strategies for Living, and we will be right back.
Reading begins not in the classroom, but in your child's brain. I'm Donisa Walker with LearningRx Shreveport. If your child struggles to read, maybe he or she has trouble focusing or comprehending, LearningRx Shreveport offers a science solution to reading problems, working one-on-one with your child, targeting his or her reading skills. Today, call LearningRx Shreveport. Make an appointment to have your child assessed. I know you want to help your child. So does LearningRx Shreveport.
You know, it's been going on for 101 years now. I'm talking about the Shreveport Little Theater. Been enriching our lives through the performing arts and education and opportunities to volunteer service guided by professional artists. They've been at it a long time. And up next, beautiful. The Carole King musical is the summer musical this year. And have you seen the 24-25 season? My goodness. Neil Simon's Brighton Beach memoirs, Steel Magnolias, It's a Wonderful Life, Doubt, I Love You, You're Perfect, Now Change, and then May We All, a new country musical. You know, you need to get your season tickets right now. ShreveportLittleTheater.com. It is American theater at its best at 812 Margaret Place in Shreveport. Shreveport Little Theater. ShreveportLittleTheater.com. And welcome back. Welcome back into Strategies for Living here on 101.7 FM, 710 Keel. I absolutely love talking about the Robinson Film Center, 617 Texas Street, downtown Shreveport. So I've been in seventh heaven this evening with Wendell Riley from the Robinson. You don't come often enough. That's my complaint. You need to come more.
I apologize for that.
No, don't apologize.
No, I'll be back soon.
I know you're busy doing all that you're doing with the Robinson, and I'm
you're
so
you're an integral part of the community.
Amen.
Thank you for that.
That's a wild thing to hear. I'm being honest. It's weird, but thank you.
Yeah. Well, thank you.
No, thank you for I doubt if you could even conceive when you came here several years ago what this would be. But thank you for coming. However, we thank the education gods or whoever got you here. I think that this is a marriage made in heaven with the Robinson Film Center and Wendell Riley. So thank you for taking the off. Thank you to the Robinson for, making it happen. Thank you for accepting it. And, I hope we talk about this many, many more years to come.
I appreciate y'all having me on. Thank you so much.
RobinsonFilmCenter.org. Check out the Movie Zone. Check out the Robbies coming up Saturday, June 15th. Check out Abby Singer's Bistro. Folks, thank you for checking out us here on Strategies for Living. And we appreciate our fine sponsors, including the Robinson Film Center and Azalea Cleaners. And Pintail Roofing,
roof.
And Learning RX, and Hempress Cannabis with Love, and the Shreveport Little Theater. If today were the last day of your life, you only had one more phone call to make, who is it that you'd call? And what would you say? And why are you waiting? Make the call. For Wendell Riley, for Lauren Leon McMillan, for Jimmy Bryant, I'm David McMillan. See you next time right here on Strategies for Living.